Hey everyone, and welcome to the Good News and Notes with Pastor Phil. We'll be looking at scripture, its meaning, interpretation, how it affects our life, and also we're going to see how the world of music amplifies the good news. So let's buckle up and jump right in.
Hey friends, it's been a while since I posted something like this, but the time has come to get back into it. Instead of interviews and so on, which may still pop up here and there, I wanted to try a jump off into the gospel for the week. It will probably be at what my sermon could be about for the coming weekend. With that said, our gospel this week comes from Matthew 20. And here it is. For the kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out early in the morning to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with the laborers for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. When he went out about 9 o'clock, he saw others standing idle in the marketplace. And he said to them, "You also go into the vineyard, and I will pay you whatever is right." So they went. When he went out again about noon and about 3 o'clock, he did the same. And about 5 o'clock, he went out and found others standing around. He said to them, "Why are you standing here idle all day?" They said to him, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You also go into the vineyard." When evening came, the owner of the vineyard said to his manager, "Call the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and then going to the first." When those hired about 5 o'clock came, each of them received their usual daily wage. Now, when the first came, they thought they were to receive more, but each of them also received the usual daily wage. And when they received it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last worked only 1 hour. You have made them equal to us who have borne the burden of the day and the scorching heat." But he replied to one of them, "Friend, I am doing you no wrong. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what belongs to you and go. I choose to give this last the same as I give to you. Am I not allowed to do what I choose with what belongs to me? Or are you envious because I am generous?" So the last came. So the last was first, and the first will be last. So friends, there's much to chew on here, and it probably brings up many questions. To be honest, I struggle with this text every time. It can be a challenge to hear that things are not often fair. Even God may not act fair as we consider life to be in this earthly kingdom. Yet God is still generous, just as is it to be in the kingdom of heaven. The gospel is life-giving, even when we cannot feel it, and yet still God is generous with God's love to all people. So with that said, I'm curious what your thoughts are, and please leave them in the replies below, and I ask that you keep them friendly and appropriate. So friends, God bless, and I look forward to hearing from you.
And there you have it, everyone. Thank you for joining us, and please join us again next time for the good news and the notes with Pastor Phil. Thank you, and goodbye.